I am a Zoho user for about 11 years. I moved all my operation to Zoho. The only application that I didn't move was Zoho Mail, because I used to be a Gmail user. Moving from Gmail to Zoho Mail was not even something I could think about. But a few months ago, I did the move. I can tell you that Zoho Mail cannot be compared to Gmail. It's not even comparable. I created here a series of videos that will show you the value of Zoho Mail. Hopefully, I will be able to convince you to check it out. If you are an existing Zoho Mail user, I recommend you to see those videos, because that will let you be more productive and efficient. If you are a manager and you have employees helping you and they're not syncing with you in the right way, Zoho Mail can fix all that. I am working with my assistants. I have two assistants that are helping me. I have large team members that are helping me. Everybody works together in a very nice way using the Zoho Mail application. So hopefully you will give me a chance to show you. In this video, I just want to give you snippets. I'm not going to dig into anything. I will just give you reasons why I think it's worth your time. In the following videos, I am going to concentrate on specific areas of the application, which will be more of a training. But right now it's a show off. I just want to show you the application and some reasons. So first of all, let's start with the left side. In Gmail, I used to click on buttons and that will create new windows for me. Here I can go to my calendar with a click of a button. Now, when you are in your calendar, you can see that I have here only one calendar, but in my live system, I have all my employees' calendars here that I can turn them off and on, which means I can see my employees' calendars if I want to. That might be that the employee is sick and I want to see what type of meetings they have today so I can switch them, or maybe the assistant's supposed to do it. But in any case, I have lots of flexibility with the calendar. When you are creating a meeting, you can have a conference by default with Zoho Meeting, but you can also have Zoom and Teams and all the rest. So that's like Gmail, nothing too special here, but that can be done. They have also a nice work agenda that you can see only the working hours, so it's limiting the time, and obviously you can change those. You can also have here the agenda, which I really like. The agenda is a list view. I don't have anything here, but it will be a list view that you can see all your events one by one. The to-do can be used in a very efficient way. So the basic will be that you will have your ways to create a task. So wash my car, and now I will have a task. So that's the most basic way. Whenever I'm in a meeting and I have a quick task, this is exactly what I would do. I will go here and I will have different categories, which obviously you can create yourself. I will have here new, I will have here on old, completed, and other people from the company will help me manage them. The unified view, if you are a Zoho user, you can see that you can have your tasks from Zoho Connect, from Zoho Peoples, from Zoho Projects, Zoho Desk. So you can see all the tasks across the Zoho ecosystem. But we are not going to go into that right now. The group section, if you click on it, you can create a board that will be assigned to more users. So let's say that Jesse is my assistant, and I will have your Jesse Lior. Let's call it follow-ups. And I can add Jesse to this board. Now, whenever I am adding new tasks, so one will be general, let's say that will be new, and this one will be on old, and one more will do completed. And now when I'm creating tasks, for example, okay, we'll call it wash my car too, I can assign it now to Jesse. So Jesse will make sure that I'm doing the follow-up, or maybe Jesse can do it for me. So now I have everything in my mail, right? I'm not moving anywhere. I'm still in my mail area. So that's something that is super useful. One more thing that is very cool, I have here the notes, and the notes can be in categories. So I can create here a new note, and that's a meeting with Jones. And I will have here point one, point two, and I will take all that. You can also have print screens being pasted here. You can add more people to this note. So for example, I can add, let's say, Jesse again. I have here only two users, so you will see Jesse a lot. So I can invite Jesse, and then Jesse and I can communicate. We'll have like a forum on the right side regarding those notes. And I think it's awesome because I'm just locked inside one area. Very, very cool. You have also here the contacts. Shockingly, you will have all the people that you are communicating with. If you're moving from other Gmail and so on, or Outlook, all those will be taken care of for you, and you will get all your contacts in one place during the migration process. Bookmarks will be any bookmark that you will have. For example, let's say that I'm creating now a new bookmark. So let's do amazing business results and the website. Good. So I will have here the website URL, and now I will have that as a new bookmark. And those bookmarks can be shared with more people. I will have those bookmarks, the categories will be based on our activities. So let's say that we have a category that for demos, because we are doing lots and lots of demos. I will have links to different systems. So whenever I am on my email, close to my tasks and the notes and my emails and my calendar, I will also have all those, which are super cool. And I can click on the link here and I can just paste it. So it's really, really fast. So that will be the left side. Resources, by the way, will be like rooms and so on, but we're not going to talk about that. So let's go back to my email. You will have here the streams. The streams are also very efficient. I will have an email that I just received. And instead of sending this email to Jesse, which that's what you will do in the Gmail, you will click on forward. You will write an email to Jesse. In this case, I will not do that. So I will just stay on the email. On the bottom, I will just write Jesse's name. Please respond. And I will click on share. Now, Jesse will receive it as a notification on her system. Yep. So that will be Jesse's system. If I will click here, you can see that my precious, which apparently it's me, I said, please respond. And now Jesse can take action on this email. Now I can give also permissions to Jesse to send emails on my behalf. I can also have Jesse with permission that I delegate to act as me. So me, for example, my real mailbox will get hundreds and hundreds of emails a day. It's not something manageable. I will have my assistants on my mailbox and they're responding on my behalf. So most of the emails that I am exchanging from my mailbox, I don't write them. I don't even know about them because most of those will be regular day-to-day things. What about this? What about that? How can I do? Nothing related to me because I will take that and I will move it somewhere else. So they are doing it for me. So with the delegation, it solved me a huge problem. On the right side, you have cool things. So let's say that I just got this email from Carol, for example. If I will click on Zoho CRM, which is one of the Zoho applications, and you have a bunch of applications that you can integrate with, not only Zoho, also others. I can say, create an email. So it will grab whatever it knows. So right now with Carol, I have only the email here and the signature. So I'm getting the email that is correct. The last name, I will need to create it myself. So let's say last name, then Artog, first name, Carol. And then if I will click on save, now it's being saved in my CRM. So I will go here to my system and I will see that I have here a new lead. Oh, this is not the one, but let's do today. Create a time would be today. Okay, so you see Carol was created as a new lead and I will be the lead owner and everything is set up properly for me. So from the email, I can create new contacts. I can create leads. I can create tickets in my support system. I can assign those tickets to my Zoho projects. I can do so many things from the email without copy paste, go here, go there, open new fields, new windows. It's just time consuming. It's not good for me. So all that can be done. One more thing, it's also available in Gmail, but I can have, for example, a new tag. I will put it red and I will say, let's say follow-ups. So I will have some emails that I will see during meetings. Some of them I need to take action immediately. Some of them not really. If it's one that I need to take care of, so let's say this email, go here to tag as follow-up and you will see that I have here this small thing. There is also one more setting that whenever I have, let's say a red tag, there will be a line here that will be, the entire thing will be red. Not only it will say follow-up, the entire row will be red, which for me, I need those visual confirmations. I need the colors because I'm running very fast. If it's red, I take action. And I think it's also, it's very, very nice. You can also create different views. So whenever you are viewing your emails, you can watch them based on different tags, for example, or you can view them using flags. So if you have here, for example, some emails that are important or you need a follow-up, you can do it also with flags. I personally work with tags, but it's all great. So whatever you do, it's awesome. The entire way that you are working with the email system can be configured. You can click here, see the emails on the right side. You can see them on the bottom. It can open a new page. You can customize the way that you are sending emails. So I came from Google, for example. I like the view of the Google Compose area. They created a template for me. I click on a button and it will look exactly, and you will see it in the following emails. It will look exactly like Gmail because this is what I like. Maybe you like something else. You can customize it as you want. You have your abilities to create shared mailboxes that I will show you also later on, but on the bottom, I will have your shared mailboxes that multiple people can see at the same time. It's keeping also the log of who did what. So I know if someone deleted the emails, if someone clicked on it and so on. You have ability to monitor what your employees are doing. You can override your users. For example, if an employee went for vacation for 2 weeks, which happened to us many times, the employee didn't set up an out of office notification. They're now on vacation, people sending them email, receiving nothing. There is a problem. Because Zoho Mail is such a great system, I have multiple options. First of all, I can delegate their mailbox to me so I can see what happened until now. I can also take over their mailbox and apply out of the office message. There are endless things that I can do. Let's assume that you have an employee did something terrible. The employee knows that you're going to fire him and the employee deleted all their emails and put it in the trash and click delete forever. And only after a week you see it. We have a way to have retention. And this retention, we can go back and we can pull deleted emails, not in the trash, like really deleted. There are lots and lots of abilities that we can do. So right now I will stop because I can go until tomorrow. The Next video, I will touch on certain area of the system and we'll take it from there.